Hey guys, we're going to review the Goblet Box Squat. I love the Goblet Box Squat as a teaching tool, teaching our athletes how to effectively hip hinge, and it gives us that tactile cue because we're using the box, so we can really kind of change the height to match their ability if there's someone that's new to squatting, starting with a higher box. If you have a box like this, this is an Elite FTS squat box. It has three different heights. We can start with the highest setting, we can go down to a little bit lower, which would be here, and then we can go to the lowest, which would be here. Okay, so for the sake of this video, I'm just gonna go with a 16-inch box. We're gonna grab our kettlebell, press it against our chest, keeping the elbows in nice and tight to the body. I like to go starting off with people with about a medium stance where we're sitting back, keeping the spine engaged, not rounding over, and then standing up, sitting back, and up, okay? So we can obviously vary the height, we can vary the amount of load that we're using, we can also vary the stance. Now, a lot of times, your athletes that don't know how to hip hinge yet, maybe they have an endurance background where they haven't used their posterior chain since 1983, you can have them start in a wider stance where they really have to push their knees out and get the hips back to the box. Now it's an exaggerated movement pattern in the sense that we're really forcing them to put their butt back and engage the glutes and hamstrings, all right? So that would be the audience that would use that well and would allow them to really kind of learn how to hip hinge and use that musculature that we're trying to work, okay? So again, so we're sitting back on each rep, but when we sit back, we're still keeping a nice lumbar curve. We're not rounding over. Sit back, explode up.